What's going on, people? It's SGZ here from the Spartan Game Zone, and in this video I'll be showcasing the Blade Fury, another brand new assault rifle obtained as part of the final vault card from the Director's Cut. The vault card is called Bunker Masters, featuring mystical themed items as we gear up for the release of Tiny Tina's Wonderlands. What's more magical than a gun that shoots blades, and that's exactly what this is, serving as one of the most unique and powerful weapons in the game. I'll be explaining why it's so good and how you can get this gun dealing some ultimate damage. If you enjoyed the video, I'd appreciate it if you could drop a like, and maybe you'd want to hit that subscribe button or even follow me on Twitter, and let's crack into it. So the Blade Fury is a Jacobs assault rifle with a twist, and a big twist at that. It fires at a steady pace, deals high damage, and handles well. However, there is no ricochet effect here, as it doesn't fire bullets, it fires blades, or more accurately, butter knives, which fly from its barrel and slice up the competition. It comes in two key variants, Gatlin and Masher. The Gatlin variant is fully automatic with a fixed 20 round mag, whereas the Masher version fires 4 projectiles per shot at the cost of 2 ammo with a 30 round mag. You can't go wrong with either, and it mainly depends on how you want to set yourself up. It is similar to the Face Puncher in that it deals your melee damage, but what sets it apart and makes it even better is the fact that it doesn't just dish out the punchy, it deals the shooty as well. By that I mean it deals both melee damage and weapon damage, which is a formidable combination. You can see from me testing on the dummy here that there are two numbers popping up per shot, three actually, but what's going on here is the top one is representing our weapon damage and the bottom one is dishing out our melee damage. Having a weapon that is capable of doing that is fantastic and opens up a lot of doors that have been closed for a long time. It can take advantage of both melee and elemental focused anointments, but I found elemental anointments to be better due to them boosting both of its damage sources. Kill stack is great too. Normally weapons that deal melee damage require a specific setup to get doing work, but because the Blade Fury has regular damage built in as well, every single Vault Hunter can pick this up, place it in their current build, and get to causing mayhem. It'll slice and dice those who are not so nice in an instant, and there's a number of things you can do to raise its damage output. A lot of that is to do with equipping artifacts and class mods that boost your melee damage. Going down that route will yield more damage than without, but as I said before, the great thing about this gun is that you don't have to. Its projectiles don't travel very fast, but they do deal some great damage, and Amara can increase its projectile speed dramatically when specced into heavy rain. She is also the one that has it easy when it comes to gaining its maximum damage potential. On her in a melee focused build, mobs will crumble at the very sight of you. It's here where the Masher variant outshines the Gatlin, providing more projectiles for those ricochets and downing weaker opponents in single shots. Indiscriminate provides you with that Jacobs ricochet effect, and ties that bind helps show that she cares by sharing all of its incredible damage around. Its Masher version is pretty much a shotgun, but one with huge capacity and the same mammoth damage, and that's definitely evident here. I found it worked great with the Pearl equipped, but if you want to make things even more chaotic when fighting crowds, consider equipping a static charge. It will grant you the Brainstormer effect, linking damaging shock chains between enemies that just add to the fun. A Stone Prefix will provide extra elemental melee damage, and is the best mobbing artifact for melee builds. Forget Amara and forget melee damage rolls, the Blade Fury is a furious weapon in its own right, especially while mobbing. Every character can swing its sword to cut down enemy after enemy, but add those melee skills and gear into the mix, and it gets even better. So that's all for this video, I hope you enjoyed it, learned about the Blade Fury, and how you can set it up to deal some incredible damage. If you did, consider dropping a like or subscribing, and I'll catch you in the next one.